Welcome everyone to King's Quest 4. I'm your host, Lost. King's Quest 4, that was several games ago. This is King's Quest 6, Episode 5. And the first thing that we're going to do, of course, is travel. That's why we got us here. We need to head to the Isle of the Beast because I was dumb and forgot something. Teehee. Okay, so on the Isle of the Beast, and I saw it in the background and I just didn't pay attention to it because I'm silly. Is there's a lamp that we need to go collect, and I figured we would start off by doing that. Most notably because I was silly, saw it there, and you'll see it now. In fact, there, it's almost completely different from the rest of the background, and I just neglected it. Alexander takes the old hunter's lamp from the tree. And with that, we can actually get on with what we want to do today, which is a whole lot of stuff on the Isle of Wonder. Let's get moving. Oh, let's not do it that way. Okay. So, up on the Isle of Wonder, which is over there, we need to get a couple of things. Actually, a surprising number of things. And at first glance, when you're looking at the Isle of Wonder and you're thinking how, you know, really populated is it, and it turns out to be a lot more populated than you think it is. With stuff you need to grab. Over here, there's these bottles, and we need to gather up one of those. Watch this carefully. Alexander takes a bottle of milk from the mortgage bush. Apparently the dogwood tree doesn't like Alexander standing that close. I love that, that's a great pun. Okay, so the reason why we need the milk is for these guys. We're gonna give them some milk. And now we're going to see the actual interface expand outward. It's not clear from this, but if you got more than four times three is 12, right, then you can go down here. Anyway, we don't need to do that because what we want is over there. Alexander gives one of the baby's tears a bottle of milk. The other baby's tears seem to resent Alexander's gift for some reason. Well, of course they do. So what we want to do is we want to collect some tears. Man. That's terrible. Alexander collects some of the baby's tears in the old hunter's lamp. Now, because that noise is going to get super annoying, because there's a whole whack of stuff we need to do in the screen. I'm gonna head out. And show back up again. So there's a surprising amount of things that you can do here. We're gonna start off by grabbing the old rotten tomato. Hey, what do you think you're doing there? Get your hands off me. Hey! Alexander picks up a rotten tomato and puts them away. One never knows when one will need a rotten tomato. And so there's a sparkling thing up here, which you can go grab that quickly. An elegant padded chair provides a cushy garden seat from which to enjoy the lively garden. An honored. A delicate shiny teacup. And we want that. We also kind of want this hole in the wall thing here. If we look through the hole in the wall. Oh, Alexander, don't walk all the way that way. Why would you do that? There appears to be a hole in the garden wall. Now, of course, because it's holding the wall, because we've been through here, we're going to see chest land. The hole in the wall, Alexander sees the land, resembles a giant chessboard. We know all about that. Wow, it really is a hole in the wall. What? You... Okay. Zounds. These wallflowers sure are shy, and the snapdragons are awfully protective of them. Alexander can't even get close to the wallflowers without causing quite a stir. So, if you try and... I mean, logic detects that you want a hole in the wall. Alexander decides to pick up the hole in the wall. A hole in the wall could be very useful. But, when you do... Eek! He can't catch the hole in the wall. Alexander startled the poor thing. It's run off to hide behind the wallflowers. And now, we are going to bear witness to my favorite piece of music in this game. This is amazing. So I'm going to shut up now. May I have the dots? Oh my, tea! Some text dialogues there that basically said that the wallflowers keep dancing because they're in tune with the music, and then you go and collect the wallflower, the hole in the wall, while the wallflowers are all kind of preoccupied. And I think that is it. Yeah. That is my favorite piece of music in this game. So much so, in fact, that I went and remade the piece of music in my spare time, and didn't do a great job of it. Oh well. Okay, so we need some slime. Because if you remember, the recipe called for swamp ooze. Oh wait, I'm trying to collect it in the lamp. I've got baby's tears in the lamp. I want a teacup. I'm being silly. Okay, so we want like a teacup of swamp ooze. What do you think you're doing? You saw me. I was just getting some swamp ooze. Well, you certainly won't get it here, there. That's not swamp ooze. That's swamp slime. He's right, you know, but he could be a little nicer about telling you. He's not a very pleasant stick in the mud. Nobody asked you. Be quiet. Oh, the trials of being a mere bump on the log. Okay, so you need to solve this crisis, and to do that, you are going to give Bump on the Log some ammunition. I thought this might come in handy the next time your brother starts picking on you. Aha, finally. Old Bump on the Log's not so defenseless. Is he? Hey, what are you doing there? Watch the pub, would you? Now, Bumpy, remember all I've given you? The only thing you've ever given me is mud. Take this. No, not into the swamp. I'm doing a bad job of it, but that's basically Rotten Tomato. Okay, I give up. Jeez, sorry. Well, I guess it's not very pleasant having things thrown at you. I'm sorry. You mean it? Really, brother? Brother! Stick in the mud and bump in a log, exhausted from the battle, immediately for doze off into naps. Rotten Tomato, being equally lazy, decides to join them. And this is great because now we can actually get some mud. Okay. Alexander falls a teacup with the swamp poops. Now, I would like to welcome you to this game's copy protection. Although I need to go and get, I need to go get a thing from the Isle of the Crown before we do that. I actually like this game's copy protection because, again, it's very interwoven with the manual. And I might have to show you the manual for this to make sense. But, so we need to go to the Isle of the Crown. Because the flute was the only thing we needed for that particular little journey. I'm always amazed, like, just looking at this, how, I mean, it's beautiful, and we thought it was state of the art, but if you look at some of the screens, like, here, you'll notice that there's wind going through the bushes here, but then on some of the other screens, this, like, the whole thing is just totally dead. I'll point it out when we get there, but, the screen south of here is Good Day, Prince Alexander. A very bad culprit of that. I want to give you your flute. Oh. There we go. Would you mind if I traded this in? Of course, Prince Alex. I kind of wish you wouldn't call him Prince Alex. We want the tinderbox. I believe I'll take this tinderbox. Very good, Prince Alex. Enjoy your tinderbox and bring it back at any time. Thank you. Okay, so that was all we really needed from there. Anyway, what I was saying was, if you look at this screen here carefully, you can see there's wind going through these bushes. There's nothing else going on the screen, it's just that wind. And then you look here, and anything that's moving on is a bird. It's obvious that they did this for the sake of reducing animations, because the more animations they add, the more this game would have taken. And I mean, as it stood, when this shipped, I think it was on, I want to say 9 or 12 discs or something stupid. So, you know, it was starting to get up there. Okay, so we want to go to the Isle of the Mountain, Sacred Mountain. Now, Isle of the Sacred Mountain is where you encounter all of the game's copy protection. And it's sort of cool because it's integrated with the actual, mythos of the land. If you get the manual, you get a thing called the Lands of Green Isles sort of kit book, and that helps you solve many of these problems. There appears to be something etched into the face of the cliff. Alexander decides to see it closer. Oh, pardon me, I am very sleepy. Because I'm doing this late at night, it was a long day. So what you have to do here is you've got to do rise. Huge blocks of stone erupt from the granite cliffs. And it is totally possible for you to die here, by the by. Alexander stares with wonder. That's quite a way to welcome a guest, if indeed it is a welcome. These are the cliffs of logic. Okay, so just very briefly before we actually get involved in the cliffs of logic, let me just show you that it is possible to die. It might not look like it when I do this playthrough, but it is totally possible to do that. Okay, so you can decide, awesome. I want to be on a step here. Alexander, okay. Can't hear really. Okay, well, let's just go up, go up, go up, go up, and then we'll try and trample to the right. Oh no, Alexander loses a balance. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Now that's okay, because that's a little fall, but you can die from high heights. Mandatory jumping puzzles, always bad. Ultimate 8, are you listening? Oh goodness, that game. The less we talk about it, the better. Okay, so if we head on up here, you'll notice that the clips of logic eventually give out at certain intervals, and when they do, you will end up with different puzzles. Like, here's a new puzzle. Alexander examines the strange etchings on the face of the cliff. Okay, so a master of language. Well, blah, blah, blah. This is Saw. And what you need to do here, the Isle of the Green, the Land of the Green Isles has its own language. And if you look at the manual, you'll notice that, like, these all correspond to different letters. And if you figured out that this was Saw, you would just have to, like, match one for one the words to these little icons here. And each one maps to a specific letter. So, like, for example, if I go 3 down, 1, 2, 3, and then I go 4 across, no, 3 across, 1, 2, 3, this is an S. Reading about the ancient ones and the guides in the land of the Green Isles may help a puzzle journey. S and an O. And we want to go to layer 5, 5, and then we're going to go here. I think that my notes are, yeah, my notes are, okay, it's 1, 2, 3, and then we want the lower right-hand corner. The stones beneath Alexander's feet trembles as more steps emerge from the granite cliffs. We're not going to finish all, well, actually we will. I will just kill the timer. Maybe we can make it, who knows. In my test playthrough, I never actually got through the green out, the cliffs of logic on time, so I will be surprised if we do now. Mainly because there's a lot of looking at my notes and going, where do I need to be for this? Of course, if we die, then I am just going to abandon this. So no one needs that in their life. Okay. So, this doesn't look like it, but these are numbers. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4. So what we need to do is, we need to do 3 from the right-hand side. 1 and then 4. The stones beneath it. Okay. Right, we know about that. What is kind of weird about this section is you don't actually walk using the do button, which is something I'd expect you actually use the walk button to get around. Which is kind of odd. And invented the worldwide standard of WASD for running around and this sort of thing yet, so it is all pointing and clicking. Oh, I nearly killed this there. Okay. Strange etching face glyph, alrighty. And this is a slightly different puzzle. Sacred 4, and I don't remember how you work this out, but this is QODC, OQDG. And let me just consult my notes. Yes, I'm going to be 3 down, and then 1, 2, 3, 4. 3 down, 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, that's right, because we remembered from last time that this is O. And then we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Really? 1, 2, 3, 5, 6. And then we need second letter on the bottom, which is this one. Okay, I am actually going to turn the timer off because we're very close to the end. And as soon as I get to the top, there's going to be like a little bit of a cutscene, but I will end right after that. Up we go. Okay, and then up one last bunch of stairs. And okay, so here, what you want to do is you want to type the word ascend. So, oh, yeah, I know. That's because I'm silly. I clicked in the wrong place. A, S, C, E, N, and D. It does not realistically matter. This, yeah, it doesn't realistically matter which like E you click, as long as you get the word. That's my belief anyway. I may be wrong. Because I know that like each version of the game treated this slightly differently. There we go. We're gonna save right after this. This is gonna be a funny cutscene, and then we're gonna save. Alexander finds himself finally at the top of the cliffs. Exhausted, he steps over the lip of the plateau and stands. Why do you make such an effort to climb the cliffs, young man? The winged ones who lived on this island had the power of flight. You can have it too, if only you would eat a berry from this magical flying nightshade bush. Doesn't sound legitimate at all. I mean, nightshade bush? Nightshade bush is generally deadly. The sweet berries will make you float like a petal in the wind. Try some. We're gonna ignore them. In fact, we're gonna save. Right, so we are in episode 5. And that is that for today. Thank you so much for watching. I've been your host, Lostwolfe. This has been Kingsters 5. Kingsters. I keep on getting the numbers mistaken for the game that we're in. It's that late. Kingsway 6, Episode 5. I will see you all tomorrow when we continue. Have a great evening, folks, and goodbye.